Bluetooth pair. Bluetooth connected.
Get on my elevator, baby, we're going down. Give me that now and later, I can't get enough. So much to discover, please don't stop me now. Every time I touch it, they're flying off the ground. Let them go, all the ones trying to get in the door. I will go where they all couldn't go.
Tell Adriana I said hi.
Thank you.
Okay, guys, so we're gonna go ahead and get started. We're gonna try to finish up our dance today. We just have two steps to learn, basically, and then we're gonna be finished. So go ahead and get yourself to a spot where you can move. I'm gonna switch my camera and put on the music and see what we remember. Whoa, why did it do that? That's weird. Okay, that's better. All right, let's see what we remember.
Six, seven, eight.
Get on my elevator, baby, we're going up. Give me that now and later, I can't get enough. So much to discover, please don't stop me now. Every time I touch it, they're front of the crowd. Let them go, all the ones trying to get in the door. I will go where they all couldn't go. Up a floor, up a floor, up a floor.
Stop.
questions, anything we need to go over that you don't remember? We're going to pick it up from the roll. I'll review the roll really quick, and then we'll go into our last two steps. Let me let Taylor Emily in here. Okay. Okay, so let's review the roll. So after you repeat the chorus all the way from the to the step, come together, clap, step, come together, clap. We have 16 counts or 2 8 counts of slow motion. Remember, your feet stay in one spot. We want to move, but you can use all of your reach for the upper half of your body. And we want to make sure that we end with my weight on my left foot, so I can use my right leg to go down on my knee. 1, 2, bring my left knee together. 3, 4, I'm gonna swing my leg to the front. 5, 6, back together. 7, 8, rolling. 1, 2, 3, 4, standing up. 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we're going to, with our right foot, so we step left and right, I'm going to ball change. My arm is pressing across my chest. I'm ball change. Taking my right foot back behind to do a pas de deux. Back, side, front. Then on the other side. Ball change. Back, side, front. My arms are pushing on the ball change, and then they're kind of swinging, switching on the pas de deux. So again, after we stand up, right foot, left foot, ready, or left foot, right foot, sorry, I'm backwards today. Ready for the ball change, pas de deux, other side, change, pas de deux, we're going to do it 4 times, pas de deux, last time, pas de deux. Yes? From here, I'm going to use my right foot, because it's free, I'm going to do a chasse towards my left wall. Remember, chasse is step together, step. So I'm going to chasse, step together, step. Then I'm going to rock all my weight onto my left foot. Rock left and rock right. Now I'm going to take my, this is the trickiest part of this. I'm going to take my left foot. I'm going to go over my back shoulder, face the other wall, so I can chasse this way. Chasse, step together, step. Now I'm rocking right and left. Then I'm gonna do the same thing, right foot. Gonna go around the front, front, chasse, step together, step, rock, left, right, left foot lead, step together, step, right, left. Yes? Let's try just that. That's a little bit tricky. So I finish my pas de deux like this. I'm going to chasse right, step together, step, rock left, right, use my left foot, step together, step, right, left, now turn to the front, together, step, left, right, again, step together, step, right, left. So remember, we're always kind of turning in the same direction. I'm always turning up over my left shoulder. Always turning over my left shoulder. Try that one more time. Then we'll do a little bit faster because it's faster. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. Chasse, step together, step, rock, left, right, step together, step, right, left, again, step together, step, left, right, step together, step, right, left. Yes. Let's do a little bit faster. Think with the music, it's like step together, step right, up right, step together, step right, left. Let's try that fast. Ready? Make your step small. Right, 5, 6, 7, 8, and chasse. Step left, right, chasse. Step right, left, chasse. Step left, right, again, chasse. Step right, left. I make sure that when you're shifting your weight, you're rocking, that you're really putting all my weights on my left foot and then all of it's on my right foot. If I kind of stay wishy-washy here in the middle, it makes it harder for me to remember which foot I pick up to turn to do the chasse on both sides. So try not to be wishy-washy
all my weight's here, or all my weight's here. That's not the rhythm. Let's do it that fast from the ball change. So do four of these ball change, pas de deux raise, into the chasse. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8, and ball change, pas de deux raise. Sorry, that's my arm. Pas de deux raise, ball change, pas de deux raise, ball change, pas de deux raise. Ready? Chasse. Step, left, right, chasse. Step, right, left, again, chasse. Step, left, right, chasse. Step, right, left. Yes, 10 sort of maybe. Let's do it again. Just that again, and then we'll try it. I'll see if I can find it with the music. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8. Ready? Ball, change, pas de deux, red, ball, change, pas de deux, red, again, ball, change, pas de deux, red, ball, change, pas de deux, red. Ready? Chasse. Left, right, chasse. Right, left, chasse. Left, right, chasse, right, left. So on these, all these turns, these little like kind of quick pivot turns, you want to make sure that you're trying to get your head around first when like you're spotting, so that you don't get super dizzy doing all of these turns. Try to whip your head around first. Let's see. Let's go from, probably from the roll, I think is the easiest place to find. So this is the slow motion. 2-8 counts of the song. We're going to, for the people who are going to perform in person, we're going to move into a pose. So that's after that chasse, last chasse bit, you're going to walk to where you're supposed to stand for your pose. And that's it. That's the whole dance. Let's see. Right here.
Right.
That's the whole song. Okay. Let's try it. Actually, let's take 2 minutes for some water, and then we'll do it a couple times all the way from the top. So go ahead and grab some water. You got 2 minutes.
Everybody here, except for you two, got your paper course cards this morning, right? With your class about for next year?
Yeah.
Your second grade? Who's your second grade?
ELA.
Which ELA?
ELA's a portal.
It has your all your classes that you're currently registered for next year, and it's how you can change your classes if you want to change it. At the end of class, I'll send you up to Mr. Padilla. Maybe he got it late, let you have it. You guys don't get them because you're going to high school, so your high schools will take care of them. But double check, look at your course cards, guys, because I had a bunch of sixth graders, some for some reason get listed in dance 3. So make sure you look at it and make sure it says, if you're doing dance next year, make sure it says dance 2 and not dance 3. I don't know why. But like all of them, my second period said dance 3. I have no idea. I don't do it. Okay, guys, let's do it one last time all the way from the top. We'll do our whole dance. Okay. Pretty all the way from the top. Ready? 5, 6, 7.
Get on my elevator. Baby, we're going up. Give me that navigator. I can't get enough. So much to discover. Please don't stop me now. Every time I touch it, they're front of the crowd. Let them go. All the ones trying to get in the door. Keep on climbing up.
Today, let me tell you about some of the kind of logistics for this week. So, let me bring it back over here. Hello. Okay. So this week is going to be a little bit weird because we have a whole bunch of star tests this week for eighth graders. And because the other half of classes I teach are all eighth graders, they're using me for a lot of star tests. So tomorrow, there will be no Zoom class because I have to give the eighth grade algebra star test because they told me to. So I will not be here. There will be a sub for the in-person kids and there will be no Zoom class. There will be an ed puzzle. That is for a grade, and if you're online, it's your attendance, so make sure you do it, so you're not counted absent. Then Wednesday, because I didn't know they were going to make me do the math test, I have to go to the doctor, so there will also be no Zoom class. There's a different ed puzzle. Make sure you do it for your attendance. Same thing. Everybody do it. It's a grade. It's also for your attendance. So Thursday should be a normal day. If for any reason, because that is an all eighth grade star testing day, they pull me to test, which they shouldn't because I'm not on the list, but just in case in an emergency or something, I will message you. I will put it on Schoology if we don't have Zoom because I have to give the star test. Hopefully that won't happen. Hopefully I will see you on Thursday, but just in case, double check on Thursday to see if we're having class or not. And the same thing for Friday, because that's an all eighth grade star test day again. But I'm hoping, fingers crossed, that I don't have to give that test too. Because I hate giving the star test. It makes me want to cry. So I will see you on Thursday. Make sure for the next 2 days you do the ed puzzles for your attendance and for your grade. So that's your two grades for this week, is the ed puzzles. If you have any questions about anything, you're welcome to stick around. Otherwise, you guys are free to go, and I will see y'all on Thursday. Bye. Neither of y'all are in algebra, right? No, I didn't think so. I don't think any of my eighth graders are in algebra.